This video is made possible by NordVPN. Take control of your internet experience today. Go to nordvpn.com/toptens and use the code TOPTENZ to get 68% off NordVPN. That makes it only $3.71 a month. Plus, you get an additional month for free. So take control of your internet experience now. Link below and let's get into it. We owe a lot to violence and conflict, as a big chunk of all of our technological innovations have come from violence and conflict. That makes perfect evolutionary sense too. The threat of extinction was a huge driver of innovation in the early days. If you have better swords than the rival clan, you know more about swords and metalworking and are more likely to survive and pass that knowledge on. You'd think that it is no longer the case, as technological innovation doesn't need to rely on killing each other anymore, though you'd be surprised to know that weapons are still our best made tools. Most of our top innovations in automobile technology, prosthetics, robotics, AI, and a bunch of other fields are still theorized and developed in a defense lab somewhere. If you want a glimpse into what the future would look like, just look at the weapons we're developing right now. From a crowd control pain ray, which is exactly what it sounds like, to straight up seeing through walls, these weapons of the near future prove that we're still at our innovative best when we're preparing for war. Number 8. Invisibility Cloak. A working invisibility cloak has been a staple of fiction for a long time, even if it's a pretty creepy idea in civilian situations if you think about it for more than a second. Imagine if invisibility cloaks were reality. You'd never know if you're truly alone in a room. Apply that to military situations, however, and that honestly weird idea instantly turns into one of the deadliest improvisations that we can come up with. If we can build a perfect invisibility cloak, it won't just give us a perfect camouflage on the battlefield, but could also be used to build new, unheard-of tactics. Combine that with our innovations in robotics, and we may soon have invisible killing robots that can be made to do anything behind enemy lines. While it would still take some time to come up with a Harry Potter-style invisibility cloak, we still have a lot of prototypes that are scarily close to the real thing. Number 7. Nanobots. Nanobots are sort of like Ant-Man. He doesn't sound too interesting or powerful on first look, but if you actually sit and think about the potential uses of being really, really tiny, you'd realize that it's actually one of the most overpowered abilities that one can think of. Tiny robots that can carry out advanced operations could be potentially used to do anything you want. A fact military scientists are well aware of. While we don't really know much about what the military is developing, as the best prototypes are the ones we don't know about, some recent research might give us a clue. MIT researchers have developed something very close to what military-grade nanobots would look like. They're no bigger than a grain of sand. They float in the air, and they're able to continuously produce energy. While it's still in the future, you could even expect them to have some kind of weapon of their own. Number 6. Exoskeleton. Exoskeletons are possibly one of the more futuristic technologies we know of, though it's largely due to FPS video games and Iron Man. Didn't we just talk about nanobots and invisibility cloaks? Exoskeletons, I feel like, yeah, whatever. Exoskeletons have proven to be quite inefficient in almost all of our past experiments, either due to the power required to keep them going for long periods, or simply the heat-based inefficiency of roaming around inside a giant metal suit. The idea of a robotic suit augmented with cool features is great on paper, but no one has been able to make it work. No one. Except the Russians, that is. An exoskeleton made by the Russian military may have solved a lot of those problems, and may just be the first exoskeleton that we've seen that actually works properly. Right now, the prototype allows the soldier to run faster while aiming a machine gun with just one hand. While it still doesn't have enough batteries to outlast a typical battle, they're confident that they could solve that and put a working suit on the battlefield by 2025. The USA's own exoskeleton program, Talos, may not be that far behind either, though we don't yet know much about it. Number 5. Auto-kill zones. There are growing concerns about the continuing use of AI in warfare, and justifiably so too. Automated weapons are one of the biggest threats to life on Earth, and we're not even talking about rogue AI here. We already have weapon systems that are directly challenging the morality of using automatic weapons, and these are auto-kill zones. While Israel is the only country that is currently using them on the border, other countries are developing their own versions too. And it's exactly what it sounds like. No-go zones protected by automatic weapons that can choose when to attack. The last part is the most worrying, as auto-kill zones, by definition, require the machine to take the call on who to shoot. How do you teach a machine to differentiate between combatants and civilians. Now, you might not need to protect yourself from an auto-kill zone, but if you are online, you really should be using a VPN, and that's where today's sponsor, NordVPN, comes in. I know it's tempting not to bother with a VPN and sort of just hope for the best, but really, those stories you read about online, people having their data stolen, it really does happen, and we don't want that to be you. Maybe it's a nefarious actor snooping for private information or a company tracking your activity. But using a VPN can also be about so much more. For example, NordVPN lets you access any of its thousands of servers in different countries all around the globe. So if you've hit the end of your Netflix queue, simply try switching over to a different location and get access to content libraries that, due to licensing agreements, are only available in specific geographic locations. I personally ran into that with Mad Men a while ago, and a few other shows, so it's pretty darn handy. NordVPN is super fast, so watching videos is a breeze. There's no lag whatsoever. If you've ever used VPNs and thought they were slow, well, no more with NordVPN. And you can use it on all of your devices very easily, and use it on 6 different devices with just 1 account. Also, there are no logs at all. Unlike companies based in the EU or the US, NordVPN is over in Panama, so they didn't have to keep logs at all, which is great for your privacy. So take control of your internet experience now at nordvpn.com/top10s. Use code TOP10s to get 68% off NordVPN and an extra month for free. And let's get back to the video. Number 4, EMP. When it comes to weapons of mass destruction, we always think of nukes or chemical weapons. While they're definitely the most lethal for human life, there are other weapons that can make life on Earth very difficult too. An EMP, or electromagnetic pulse gun, is one of them. It's a theoretical weapon that can wipe out all electrical systems in a given area, and if that doesn't sound life-threatening, consider that almost every part of our life, including heating, GPS, cooking, etc., depends on electricity. As the world gets more and more digitized, a total EMP wipeout would hinder life in a variety of ways in most parts of the world. While we don't have a full-fledged EMP ray machine just yet, which is probably how everyone is imagining it, we do have the technology to build it. Known as CHAMP, short for Counter Electronics High Power Microwave Advanced Missile Project, the project has already been successfully tested in Utah in 2012 when it was used to shut off the systems of a targeted area. Number 3, the pain ray. With the global economy faltering and unrest growing in many major countries around the world, governments are increasingly investing in crowd control tech to bolster their chances of not being overthrown by their people. To that end, many countries have developed something called an ADS, or active denial system. It could be understood as a huge machine with invisible rays that would start by gently warming up your skin and moving on to outright burning you from the inside if you don't move out of its range. It's non-lethal, but that's not necessarily a good thing when it comes to pain. As seen in protests around the world, non-lethal weapons are actually used with much more impunity, as they don't kill and cause a major problem, while still discouraging the protesters from organizing. The ADS might be a good thing for stabilizing conflicts in many parts of the world without causing casualties, though it could as well be used to quell dissent at home. To no one's surprise, China is also building an ADS of its own. Number 2, X-ray vision. Seeing through walls is another one of those fictional powers that sounds cool at first, though the more you think about it, the creepier it sounds. In combat situations, though, it could be a ridiculously powerful weapon, completely transforming counterinsurgency as we know it. It's not too far into the future either. MIT has already built an AI that can see through walls, except for now it can only read the radio waves inside the room. That means that it needs some kind of input from inside the room, like a phone signal, to reconstruct it on the screen, and you'd only be able to see the general outline with stick figures. While that's not the perfect X-ray, it's still really close to completely reconstructing any space just based on signals from inside. Number 1, autonomous cyber weapons. Cyber warfare is one of the biggest threats to global peace, and by extension human life, as anyone with control of our digital networks is also in control of our nuclear launch codes. Combine that with other upcoming tech like AI, and cyber warfare could possibly be as lethal as any other weapon we've ever made. Worryingly, that is much closer to happening than we may realize. According to many experts, automated cyber weapons are the next natural step in the evolution of cyber warfare. An AI that can hack and learn from its mistakes may sound like the stuff of fiction, though there are many viruses and other malware that already sound that way. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do smash that thumbs up button below. Don't forget to subscribe. Please do check out our fantastic sponsor, NordVPN, and thank you for watching.